Good morning. So we shall continue our discussion on the formation of partial differential equation by elimination of arbitrary. We have seen arbitrary constant, arbitrary function. So the next one is the formation of PDE. So it's formation of a PDE, partial differential equation, by elimination of arbitrary function f from the equation f of phi comma z equal to 0. So let's see. So let phi equal to phi of x comma y comma u and z equal to z of x comma y comma u be given differentiable functions. Given differentiable function. Consider f of phi comma z equal to 0. So let's name this as equation 1, where f is an arbitrary function of two variables such that f phi square plus f z square is not equal to 0 for each choice of f. Now differentiate 1 with respect to x and y. So we are differentiating partially. That is now when I differentiating with respect to x and to y, differentiating equation 1 with respect to x and y, we get let's do f. Now f is a function of phi and z. So do f by do phi into, using chain rule, let's do phi by do x plus do phi by do u into do u by do x plus do f by do z into do z by do x plus do z by do u into do u by do x equal to 0 and do f by do phi with respect to y. So it's do f by do phi into do phi by do y plus do phi by do u into do u by do y. So it's u and it's y plus do f by do z into do z by do y plus do z by do u into do u by do y equal to 0. Now if you observe these two equations as an homogeneous system, since f phi square plus f z square not equal to 0, it's a homogeneous system in terms of dou f by dou phi and dou f by dou z, and has a non-trivial solution. So since it is, this system has non-trivial solution, because of this we can write, we have the determinant of that is 2 cross 2 matrix, where entries are this one, a first entry, second entry, third entry, fourth entries. That's the coefficient matrix has determinant 0, that is determinant of dou phi by dou x plus dou phi by dou u into dou u by dou x dou z by dou x plus dou z by dou u into dou u by dou x dou phi by dou y plus dou phi by dou u into dou u by dou y dou z by dou y plus dou z by dou u by dou y. It's coefficient matrix. Since it has a non-trivial solution, determinant is equal to 0. Now expanding the determinant, so we get it is dou phi by dou x plus dou phi by dou u into dou u by dou x into dou z by dou y plus dou z by dou u into dou u by dou y minus dou phi by dou y plus dou phi by dou u into dou u by dou y multiplied by dou z by dou x plus dou z by dou u into dou u by dou x equal to 0. 0. So now taking the yes, now going forward, this gives dou phi by dou x into dou z by dou y plus dou phi by dou x dou z by dou u, and this one is dou u by dou y plus dou phi by dou u dou u by dou x dou z by dou y plus dou phi by dou u by dou x dou z by dou u by dou y. Now with respect to this, it's minus of dou phi by dou y into dou z by dou x plus dou phi by dou y into dou z by dou u into dou u by dou x plus dou phi by dou u by dou x y into dou z by dou x plus dou phi by dou u by dou y into dou z by dou u into dou u by dou x equal to 0. Now combining the terms with respect to ux, that is dou u by dou x dou u by dou y, and the remaining terms, so first we shall consider the remaining terms. So with respect to this, that is dou phi by dou x into dou z by dou y. Now this has a uy term, so I'm not using this. This has ux. Now this has ux uy, but here this term has ux uy. Moreover, dou phi by dou y, dou z by dou u, similarly dou phi by dou u, dou phi by dou u. So these two terms get cancels. So now minus dou phi by dou y into dou z by dou x plus with respect to ux, that is with respect to this, that is now dou phi by dou u into dou z by dou y. Now ux is here, so it is minus of dou z by dou y into dou phi by dou y. Dou u it is. Dou u. So it's dou u and dou y. Is it correct? Yeah, it's wrong now. I have made a mistake. So it's dou z by dou u. Dou phi by dou y. Yes. Now into dou u by dou x, so we should write take it as a ux plus with respect to dou. Now these two terms are over, these two over. Now with respect to dou u by dou y, that is uy, so it is dou phi by dou x into dou z by dou u minus this term, that is dou z by dou u, is it correct? Yes. It's dou phi by dou x, dou phi by dou u into dou xi by dou x into dou u by dou y, that is uy equal to 0, equal to 0. So using the Jacobian, we can write as dou phi comma xi divided by dou x comma y plus the next term is, this one is dou phi comma xi by dou u comma y into ux plus the last term is dou phi comma xi divided by dou x comma u uy equal to 0. Now observe, this is a first order equation, a differentiation of first order. So it's a first order partial differential equation. Moreover, you observe that the coefficient of ux ui contains the terms independent variable x, y and u. Therefore, it's a quasi-linear equation. It's a first order quasi-linear partial differential equation. Now using this explanation, we shall find the partial differential equation by eliminating the arbitrary function f from the problem. So obtain the partial differential equation by eliminating the function f from f of xy by u comma x minus y by u. Say, let's take this equation number 1. So solution, now this one is acting as phi, this one is acting as xi. So take phi is equal to xy by u and xi is equal to x minus y by u, where u is a function of x and y. Then my equation 1 becomes f of phi comma xi equal to 0. Let's call this as equation 2, where f is an arbitrary function of 2 variable. Now differentiating this 2 with respect to x and y, we get, so it is dou f by dou phi as we seen in the above, into, now differentiating phi with respect to x, so phi is nothing but xy by u, so it is y by u plus dou f dou phi by dou u, so it's u in the denominator. So we get it is xy by u square using my quotient rule into ux, into it is because it's u into differentiation of xy with respect to u is 0 and minus xy into differentiation of u is 1 and differentiation of u with respect to x is dou u by dou x plus again dou f by dou xi into differentiation of xi with respect to x, so it's x minus y by u, so it is 1 by u, again it's plus differentiation of xi with respect to u, so u in the denominator, so it is divided by u square and difference u into differentiation of xy is 0, it's plus 0 minus x minus y into differentiation of u, that is 1, into ux equal to 0, it's plus, yeah. Similarly, differentiating with respect to y, we get dou f by dou phi. Differentiation of phi with respect to y, it's x by u minus xy by u square, that is differentiating phi with respect to u into ui, plus dou f by dou xi into differentiation of xi with respect to y, it's minus 1 by u, plus the differentiation of phi with respect to u, that's as it is, so it, we will get it as minus x minus y by u square into ui equal to 0, equal to 0. So now observe that these two equations are a homogeneous equation in dou f by dou y and dou f by dou xi, that is we have, so we shall simplify and write. So it is y by u minus xy by u square, and the second term is 1 by u, and it is minus x by u square minus y by u square, so it's plus y by u square, so it is minus x by u square ux plus y by u square ux. So let's simplify this. And second row, first term, first column, that is x by u, that is this, and xy by u square into uy. Yeah, here let's write ux. Okay. And with respect to this, that the last term, minus 1 by u minus x by u square ui plus y by u square ui, and determinant equal to 0 to have a non-trivial solution. So we have, by considering this as a system of two homogeneous equations in dou phi by dou xi, we get now expanding this determinant, we get it is y by u minus xy by u square ux into minus 1 by u minus x by u square ui plus y by u square into ui minus x by u minus xy by u square into ui 1 by u x by u square ux plus y by u square ux equal to 0. Now multiplying, so it is minus y by u square minus xy by u cube ui, again it's plus y square u cube into ui minus plus, so it's xy into u square ux u cube, that's this one into this one, and it is plus x square y by u square into ux ui minus xy square by u power 4 ux ui. Next, with respect to the second, it's minus of, now it's x by u square by u square minus xy xy, is it correct? Let's see. Yeah, xy by u cube into ui plus x square by u cube into ux, not plus, it is, I think it's minus. Yeah. Minus, and it's plus x square y by u power 4 ux uy plus xy by uq ux minus minus xy square by u power 4 ux uy equal to 0 equal to 0. Now xy u cube xy u cube into uy and xy by u cube xy by yeah minus of this and minus minus of this it cancels and xy u cube ux xy u cube ux again these two get cancels xy square u by u power 4 xy square u power 4 ux these two get cancels so we remain with the okay second so we get it as minus y by u square 2 3 4 5 6 Yeah, see, x square y by u square. No, 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 not this. Yeah, this is x for 4. Because with respect to this, yeah, correct. Now, these two terms again get cancels. So, we remain with plus y square by u cube uy plus x square by u cube ux and minus x by u square equal to 0. Now making a common denominator we get it is minus u into y plus y square uy plus x square ux minus x into u equal to 0, x equal to u into 0, that is x square ux plus y square uy equal to x in, u into x plus y is the required partial differential equation of the given problem. So similarly we can solve the rest of the problem. So we shall move forward. So the next concept is Cauchy's problem for first order equation. Cauchy's problem for first order equation. So general form of first order partial differential equation in two independent variable x and y for an unknown function u is given by its f of x comma y comma u comma ux comma uy equal to 0. Let's call this as equation number 1. Now we shall find the family of all the solutions of one and identify a particular one by imposing a condition in addition to equation 1. So we shall find the solution of equation 1 and identify a particular one by to the family of all solution. The family of all solution we are applying some conditions. Under some condition we are identifying a particular solution. The finding of such particular solution is formulated in the Cauchy's problem. So let x naught of eta y naught of eta comma u naught of eta be three arbitrary functions of single variable eta defined on a real interval i
variable. Let x naught dash of eta comma y naught dash of eta be piecewise continuous on the same interval. And x naught dash square plus y naught dash square is not equal to 0 on I. The Cauchy problem for 1 is to find the domain D, in xy plane, containing this x naught of eta comma y naught of eta and for all eta belongs to I, and a solution u of x comma y, that's u is equal to u of x comma y of 1 such that u of x naught of eta comma y naught of eta must be equal to u naught of eta for all eta belongs to I. So geometrically this x is equal to x naught of eta and y is equal to y naught of eta represents two curve, represent a curve, say gamma, in xy plane. And we call this gamma as datum curve. DATUM, datum curve. The Cauchy problem is to determine a solution of one, in the neighborhood of this gamma, such that u x comma y takes prescribed value, take the prescribed value u naught of eta on gamma, So on this we have observed in a plane by considering u, that's u naught, the we can observe in a space, by say x naught of eta, and u naught of eta represent a curve, say it's capital gamma, in x comma y comma u space. The Cauchy problem is to find the integral surface. Yeah, we have seen that. So a solution in the space, is nothing but a surface. In a plane, it is a curve. So in a space, it is a surface. So our problem, Cauchy problem, is to find the integral surface. That is u is equal to u of x comma y comma u of 1 such that it passes through gamma. So as we seen in the plane, so u of x comma y is such that the solution of 1 in the neighborhood of gamma, but in the case it passes through the capital gamma, that's the integral surface containing gamma. Thank you. We shall see the next one in the next class.